Today we're going to learn how to build a spiker box. Let's get started. We're going to need a few items first. We're going to need a soldering iron, some solder, and we're also going to need a few tools. A pair of scissors, some wire clippers, some wire strippers, a 9-volt battery, and finally, some silly putty to hold our boards down while we're soldering. Let's have a look what's in the kit. We have a printed circuit board, your color may vary, a piece of tubing, 2 pieces of wood, and 4 screws and bolts, 3 ICs and chip holders, a speaker with connector, 3 stickers, 7 resistors, and 8 capacitors, 2 needles, some speaker wire, and an RCA connector, and finally 6 various connectors we'll place on the PCB. The first step we're going to do is to solder the components onto the PCB. We're going to begin with the top row connectors, and then we'll work our way back down. The first component we're going to place will be the 8-inch audio jack. This allows you to connect your spiker box to an external device like an iPad. We're going to take some silly putty and make sure that it presses down directly into it. This will hold it in place while we do our soldering. Next, we're going to place the power switch that will allow us to turn on and off our spiker box. Next, we're going to put the LED in place, which will allow us to know when the spiker box is powered on. The last connector is the RCA plug that goes into J1. You'll have to apply some force as it is a tight fit. So now we're going to install the resistors. Each unique value of a resistor has a unique color band. For example, a 33K ohm resistor will have orange, orange, orange as its color bands. The instruction sheet will tell you the resistor number, the color band, and the value for each resistor used in the spiker box. You can find the position of each resistor by looking for the resistor number on the PCB board. Bend the leads of the resistors and insert them into their proper location. Resistors don't have a polarity, so it doesn't matter which way they go in. Also note that there may be some empty spaces, for I'm not going to populate all the resistors on the board. You'll find that the resistors will stay in place better if you bend the leads on the bottom side of the board. Okay, let's quickly finish up the rest of these resistors. And good. Now let's work on the capacitors. We're going to start with the small ones on the left first. If you take a magnifying glass, you'll be able to read small numbers printed on the capacitors. For example, capacitor C7 is a 0.47 microfarad. It will have a 474 printed on it. Now let's install the capacitors just like we did for the resistors. Note that these 7 capacitors do not have a polarity, so they can be installed in either direction. I find it to be a lot easier to put all the capacitors in first and then solder. Okay, let's go ahead and install the rest of the capacitors. We're going to turn the board over, we're going to solder it, and then clip the leads as well. That is looking very good, and we're almost done. Our last capacitor is the large 220 microfarad capacitor. It is the only one that has a polarity. You'll notice that one of the sides of the capacitor will have a stripe on it. That indicates the cathode or negative side of the capacitor. It's important to position this capacitor so that the stripe faces the edge with the connectors on it. Excellent. Just a few more steps and we'll be finished. And now it's time for the chip holders. A chip holder has a notch on one end. When you install the chip holders, make sure that you align the notch so that it matches the PCB board. And now comes the fun part. We get to install the battery. I like to solder the battery posts with the battery connected. This helps ensure that the posts are straight and aligned for the battery. You'll need to figure out the orientation of the battery so you can put the posts in the right position. Once the battery is installed, we can actually do our first test to see if the LED comes on. Good. Looks like it's working. It's time to solder our last piece. We need to install the 2 posts for the speaker connector. Make sure you place the male end on the PCB with the long leads facing up. Our PCB is now complete, but we still need to install 3 chips. We're going to need to read the numbers off of the chips. If you have very good eyes, you can read the chips directly. But if you're like me, I use a magnifying glass. Also note the dot in the corner. This indicates pin 1. We need to align this pin so it faces the half moon side of the chip holder. The first chip we're going to install is the 80623. This is our bioamp, and we're going to place it in the chip holder closest to the RCA port. Next is the TI-2272, which is our amplifier and filter. And finally, the LM386, our speaker amplifier. Congratulations, you are now done with the PCB assembly.